Once again, beloved, we greet everyone in the mighty name of Jesus. Before we start the preaching, look at seven people around you. Just bless them. If early this morning you want to be blessed, find seven people. Just tell them, be blessed. 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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, we must learn to bless others. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because when we are blessing others, we will be blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is one way also of expressing what the Lord can do into our life. Beloved, today we are reading in the book of John, chapter 1. John chapter 1.
Jean chapitre 1.
We will read the first verse.
To dans la première verset à l'ouest.
And the verse 12.
Dès qu'il y en a la douzième.
John chapter 1.
Jean 1.
Let us read verse 1.
To dans la verset à l'ouest.
And verse 12.
Na ya somme na libale.
In the beginning.
Na ebandeli.
Was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Verse 12. But as many as received
Him,
that means the Word that was in the beginning, but as many as received
Him,
to them He gives the power to become sons of God, to those who believe in His name, who were born not of blood, not of the will of the flesh, not of the will of man, the will of God. Hallelujah. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. But as many as received
Him,
the one who was in the beginning, He gave them power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are continuing to preach the word, and we want these things to be settled. The vision must be very clear. We are the assembly of God, or the church of God, that is preaching and teaching the word of God with simplicity, that we may understand the things that is in, that we may not run in vain. Hallelujah. We don't like you to work in vain. We don't like you to pray in vain. We don't like you to serve in vain. We don't like you to do anything in vain. That's why you must guarantee your running with the word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You must guarantee your running with the word. Because from the beginning of everything, we see the word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That word is coming again into your life. Can you say amen? That word is coming again into your life. Because of that word that your way. The way you will receive it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The way you will receive it is the way will help you. Even something did not start yet, it will happen. It will start into your life. Tell your neighbor, receiving the power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Receiving the power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This scripture found its origin. Because all of us, when we come to God, we realize the ability, the greatness of our God. We know that we cannot do nothing on our own except we get anything from Him. We start by Ephesians chapter 3. Verse 20, where the Bible says, God is able to do more than what we can ask of
Him.
But according to the power, His power that is at work in us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We realize the ability of God that invites everyone in this place to be available in the way of prayer, in the way of thinking, in order to activate a power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And last Sunday, we saw how a child can receive gifts from his father. We were talking about the prodigal son, how he received from his father through the help of the servant of his father, how he received the robe, the garment that was the picture of the kingdom, how he received the ring that was the picture of the power and the authority related to the covenant. Because wherever we see the ring, we can see how the covenant has been established. How he received the shoes of the standard. That was the picture of the gospel and the glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
These three things cannot be separated. The kingdom, the power, and the glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, the kingdom, the power, and the glory cannot be separated. Hallelujah. It's the things that is in the presence of God. That's why we have to seek for the kingdom. Hallelujah. That's why we have to be empowered. That's why we have to receive glory, that He may be glorified. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It becomes very important. Why? Because we can see how these three things related to God. You know the robe, the garment of royalty, is that established the kingdom. But in a simple way, how the kingdom of God can be established, how God can establish His kingdom is when God comes Hallelujah. As a king. And when he came as a king, his kingdom will come with him. And that kingdom will be established. Now, in your life, in your family, in your church, how God can come to dwell, to be established. Hallelujah. The Bible says, God sits among the presence of his people. That means prayer, worship is what brings him in and it brings his kingdom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Very, very important. Now, number two, how the power and the authority can be established. How can you establish the power? How can you establish discipline? It can be established by his word. Hallelujah. That means his word is what brings the authority and the power. Hallelujah. Now, how the glory must be established. Hallelujah. Do you know how Moses received the glory? He received the glory by asking. That means by praying. Hallelujah. He asked the Lord for his glory. That means prayer can be or can establish the glory. That word, praise and worship, word of God and prayer cannot be out where the presence of God is. Hallelujah. When we go back in the beginning, before everything starts, the Bible says God used to have three big angels. What we call archangel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We used to have Lucifer. If you want to call him Lucifer yourself. We have to have Gabriel. If you want to call him
Gabriel.
And we used to have Michael. If you can call him me, this is the three big angels. Those that could be like a horse in heaven. Lucifer was in charge of praise and worship. Hallelujah.
Gabriel,
it was like a minister of communication. He was the carrier of the word. Wherever God could appear, for the power of God to be manifested, even for Mary to conceive,
Gabriel
was the one who could be sent. That means he was in charge of the word, of the transmission of the word. And we see
Michael.
Hallelujah. Anytime someone is praying, the answer to a prayer, the one who could bring it was Michael. He was like the angel of war. If things get delayed, he could fight. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When Lucifer wants to go beyond, he used to offer presents and he fell. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And since he fell, anyone who wants to worship God, he wants that person to worship
him.
He was beautiful, created to offer praise. Since the day iniquity was because he wants to ascend. He refused to do what he was created to do. Let me tell you, when you refuse to do what you were created to do, you will fail short to your destiny and where you're supposed to be. Because he refused. He wants to get that glory. That
prayer.
They make him fell down. And the Bible says, when he was falling down, he fell with the one third of the angel. Because every big angel used to have a quarter of angels. That's why one third of angels, they fell with him. The two thirds, the one for Gabriel and the one for Michael, remain there. Let me explain to you. Even you can be attacked right now by those so-called demons. They were only among one third. You still have the truth. When the truth can be on your side, I don't see why, if really it can succeed into your life. Hallelujah. Because at least you have the guarantee. Hallelujah. And those guarantee is Gabriel that symbolized the word, and Michael that symbolized the prayer. A child of God, at least you know that you can get the word of God. You can pray. If you can get this food, let me tell you, with a spirit of submission, because one is missing is prayer and worship. If you can take this, combine right now with the word and the prayer, there is no that can make you fail. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That means the word becomes very important. And the number one for you to succeed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Very, very important. That's why the devil is in the business. He don't like people to go to church. He don't like people to pray. He don't like to worship. He tried even to steal the praise and the worship. Sometimes we try even to minimize it. But in the presence of God, the praise and worship, the prayer, the word of God, the combination of these things,
you
start to make a change.
Someone
become very dangerous. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We must be like David. Seven times by day he could praise God. Three times he could pray. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he could meditate. In order to be empowered. That word is coming into your life right now. Hallelujah. There is no way we can separate this thing. Make sure in your family, make sure in your life, make sure in you that you are praising God, you are worshiping God, you are listening to Him, you are praying, and you will start to see things start to be established. Hallelujah. That's why we discover how in the number one first
place,
if you receive Jesus, that is the word of God, that you get the power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will get the power. Jesus is the word of God.
Let me tell you.
Jesus is the word of God. He was in the beginning. He was God. He was with God. Even when things become waste, Papa God could use that word again. in order to reconcile everything with him. Let us go in the book of Mark chapter
9.
Hallelujah. Mark chapter 9.
Mark 9.
Let us read from verse 22. Verse 22, the Bible says, and often he is throwing him both into the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if you can do anything, let us start from verse 21. So he asked his father, how long has this been happened to him? And he said, from childhood. And often he is throwing him both in the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if you can do anything, if you can do anything, have compassion on us and help us. This was the request of one father, his child was under demonic attack. His child was busy going to be destroyed. But when that father bring his child to the disciples, they will not do anything. But when he see Jesus, he went to him. Hallelujah. Because Jesus is the beginning of everything. He asked him if he can do anything. That was a prayer. Hallelujah. Verse 23, Jesus said to him, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. You go to the Father. You go to Jesus. You go in prayer to ask anything. Ask the Lord to do anything. In whatsoever that you want the Lord to do, the Lord also ask you a question. He says something. You say, God, if you can do anything,
as
compassion that I may find
in
us. But Jesus said to you, if you can believe, all things will be possible to whom you believe. That means even in your asking, if the power of the world, the power of faith, cannot be activated in you, you cannot experience totally what you are expecting
for.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Prayer is very important. But faith that can be raised in you, that can come to the word of God, is a mark from any impossibility to become possible. Hallelujah. That means you cannot just pray for prayer. We saw it last Sunday. That prodigal son could pray, could fast. But until he comes back home, when he can be connected, it was where he received the gift from his father. That means there is some prayer. Can seem to be prayer. You can do it in prayer because the result will be
wrong.
Hallelujah. In Mark 11, verse 23, the Bible says this: for as surely I say to you, whoever said to this mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, does not doubt into his heart, but believes that those things he said, he will have what Eva ise.
Ako evo kokisa malolenge alobaki.
Hallelujah. That means in any of your asking.
Na bosenga na yo nyonso.
If there is not any a believing part.
Soka zana eteni ya kondima
te. That can come from the word of God. Sometimes you cannot get.
Oka kozwate.
Whatever you are expecting.
Oza laki kozela.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But believe that those things he said will be done and he will ever whatever he said. This word put faith first. That means he put the word of God first. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor. For you to get power. For God's ability to operate in your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The power that you can get, that can be at work in you. In your prayer time is a man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That means that word that will bring faith in you is what we call Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why the Bible says in John chapter 1 verse 12 that those can receive the word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those that can receive Jesus, they will receive power to become whatever. Hallelujah. That means when you receive, you will receive power. That means don't reject Jesus. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the light. It's what even we call salvation. Hallelujah. Everything must start by receiving Jesus. Anytime you receive the word of God, you receive Jesus. You put yourself in a place to receive power that will be activated in your life. For God's ability to be manifested in your life. Number one requirement, receive Jesus into your life. Amen.
Amen.
Now there is a catch. Because the Bible says that is not the will of the flesh or the blood, but it will be the will of God. I will bring you in few minutes to the will of the Father. That is the very best place for you and for me to reach. Because salvation is a package of many things. Hallelujah. Do you know salvation number one is a gift? According to Ephesians chapter 2, from verse 8 to verse 9, the Bible says, by the grace of God, through faith, we receive the gift of salvation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Salvation is not something you work for. Because if you could work for, it will never be a gift. It will be a wages. Hallelujah. Salvation is a gift. It's like someone coming into your life. He wants to offer you a gift. You can receive it or refuse it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why right now there is a gift for everyone. That's why the Bible said many as many. Don't say it's only for pastor. For apostles, it's for everyone. As many they can receive. That means you must put yourself in a place to receive the gift. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because it's a gift that comes from above. Jesus is a gift for you to be saved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
No matter what you are going to do, are you willing to accept the will of God that is not
gift.
Because right now many people sometimes they try even to change the doctrine. In salvation, we must understand first that is the gift. In that salvation, what we receive is eternal life. That means in salvation, by receiving Jesus, you don't receive something for 1 minute. You are receiving something that will never end. God is not a liar. Hallelujah. Jesus is the truth. That means when you receive Him, you receive eternal life. It's not for a few minutes, for the pleasure for some time. It's for eternity. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many people, they think when they will die, is when they will receive eternal life. No, beloved. You have eternal life when you receive this gift of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That means it's when you are in this earth, is what you will guarantee even your future. Salvation is not only to receive healing and
healing.
It's something that goes beyond. The Bible calls it eternal life. That means the life of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not only when you will die physically. It starts. Tell your neighbor when you die to yourself. Oh, you did not catch it. That means when you die
on
yourself is when eternal life starts. I'm not talking when you will die physically, but when you will die on your will. That means it will never be your will. You say, Lord, not my will, but your will be done. In whatsoever I'm going to, I die in myself. I die. If I can live, I will not live it in my will. I will live in the will of yours.
Amen.
That means you die on yourself. Tell your neighbor, you have to die on yourself to guarantee that eternal life. Church today, they did not die on themselves. Do you know why? Just try to trample on them. You will see how they can work. That means you will see how they will expect. They will show you who they are. Every time you are in the church, you think you can show up. You did not activate this eternity, this eternal life. Are you understanding? That's why this message of the cross, a Christian is the one who died daily. That means daily, I'm not doing what I want. Daily, I have my Lord, I have my Master, my life that I live right now. The life of God. Why I'm trying to talk it like this? A giver is the one who can take control over someone. You know, if I come to your life, if I will give you money, if I will give you house, let me tell you, you know, we are in this country. You know, the government, when they give you money, when they give you house, is controlling your life. The controller of your life. Why? Because he decides, I can give you a small house or big. I can give you big money or not. He is the one who controls you. As you can receive, that means you subject me to control you. We are here. If we refuse to be controlled by the government, you will never receive what the government. In other way, a receiver is the one who submits to the giver. Are you submitting in that state, you make Jesus your Lord. There are many that are here. They are controlling their life themselves. The way they will speak, the way they will answer, the way they will come to church. All you can see in there is them, 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 them. There is no God who controls their life. Let me tell you, you are a boss for your life. I know sometimes even when you are too small, we can
ask you.
It's not a problem. You have received that life. Are you submit to the gifts? Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you submit that gift, it's a continual process. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you refuse to submit, it's like you reject and you refuse. That means you are taking control. If you could take control, go ahead with your own authority, go ahead with your own power. In the face of God, the Bible says, it's not by might, it's not by power, it's by the Spirit. That means when we let the Spirit to control our life, when we let God to control our life, then his ability, then what he can provide can be effective into our life. My message of today, if you are receiving
God,
you must accept to submit to that word. That word of God may control your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Very, very important. You know, in salvation, as I say, it's a gift. There is eternal life. There is forgiveness. I don't like many people. If I can accept that gift, you can say to that people that your sin has never been forgiven. Because my Bible is very clear. In Jeremiah, the Bible is very clear. In Jeremiah 31 verse 34, the Bible says, you see, the Lord will remember no more. Psalm 103 verse 12, I will find the east and the west east.
As
far, you see by accepting that gift has been forgiven. Let me tell you, never impute anyone who has received that gift that he sees did not sin for you. If God who offered that desire not to remember no more, how many times when even sometimes we can't help people, we bring them to their own sin. Let me tell you, when you accept that gift, it's not that sin controls your life anymore. You have received the righteousness of God. In your account, you have to have a sin in your bank account. But when you accept this, you accept the righteousness that was in the account of Jesus. That means you exchange your sin. Someone, he will tell you all that plane crashed one day, it was me. But when he just accepts Jesus, one day, according to God, because that is the truth, the devil can say you are not. But when God will say, your sins, I will remember. No more. Don't let anyone educate you. When you die to yourself, and you say, I will go with Jesus, and you just go with Jesus, never let anyone educate
you.
Are you there? I'm going somewhere. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have received His righteousness. Say, I have His righteousness in my
life.
There is no sin anymore in that soul. There is the righteousness of God. Because I believe and I accept
that.
Abraham believed. He was accounted as a righteous. He did some mistakes. But by belief, the Bible said he was
accounted.
Is what is going
to happen
into your life. In salvation, we have been redeemed. Redeemed
means
pay you back. Hallelujah. Redemption. You have been bought. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 19. The Bible says, you are not your own anymore. He owns you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are not your own anymore. He owns you. Because he has been bought you with a price. Hallelujah. Say, I'm not my own anymore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He owned me. That means I belong to
him.
I become his possession. And the next scripture that follows, that I should glorify God in this body. Let me ask you a question. Are you glorifying God when you speak? Are you glorifying God when in your behavior? Are you glorifying God by dealing with something? If not, I will bring you in the last one that is in the package of salvation. Is what I call total commitment. Total commitment. Matthew chapter 7.
Matthew 7.
Verse 21. The Bible says,
it's
not all that call me Lord, Lord. The Bible says so. But it's only for those they do the will of God.
Yes.
That means Christianity
is
not only by calling alone, it's by doing. And for us this year, we will continue to do good. If we will pray, we will pray. If we will preach, we will preach. If we will
tell,
we will tell. Until it comes back, we will never stop. Because by doing what he intends to do, is there. Even that calling Lord will have a meaning. Because many they are just calling Jesus. They are calling Jesus. But they are not, let me tell you. This, get it. You will measure Christianity. You will measure a church. You will measure a believer by the doing of the will of God. Not by sign and wonders. Because the next verse that follows, the Bible says, many they will say, did we never cast demon on your
name?
Did we never perform a miracle? But in that day, Jesus will answer them, I never knew you. Listen to me. By following that scripture, if those they can cast out demons, if those they can perform miracles, one day Jesus can say, he never knew them. It's not miracle, it's not casting out demons. That the man, a child of God,
I'm
sure. for you. Are you catch that? Because they say many they will cast. Many they will do miracles. It's not by following all of them. But it's not that is what they can end. There is even some pastors. Because those the Bible is talking here, they are taught that in office. Let me tell you, if those pastors, the Bible says as many. The Bible does not say as few. That means as many they are working for God. They are If even those that are working, many, they will tell them. Jesus did not even say, I knew you, I rejected you. You know when you are saying, I can forgive, I can obey, I can do this, is much better than what you can do. Hallelujah. Amen. It's much better than what you can perform. May they be misled because of following those miracles and signs. We are not following miracles. Determine who is the great by what he can
die.
Let me ask you, between Peter and John, according to the scripture, who you can think is the great? Because even among servants of God, if you think you have 1,000, that means you will become the best than others. Let me tell you, before I came here, by the grace of God, we bought a big
place.
It's not that. For me to be the best, it's right now even if you can be alone. But if you go back now, it's that is done. Is everything. Are you understanding me? Because sometimes when you see Peter, because of Peter, just by going on, he's shallowing in. You can minimize John. He's John who said, in the beginning was the Word.
Miracle
is with John. But when you see the restoration, who Who give you the revelation? Who give you about how you see
things?
Because
Job.
And when he was doing that, he was in the Patmos
aspect.
He did not even have two members. He was alone. But what we are using right now is the revelation, is the word. Let me tell you, when Paul writes the book, he was not even in the church preaching like this. What he will use for today, for miracle and
magic.
One man was in the prison alone. But what he could use, let me tell you, it's not about the population of people. It's not about how many people they can follow. Those that
drink.
Are you understanding me? Sometimes you can
misconstrue.
The word of God is not confusing. Because those they wrote this
part,
the date of New Testament,
was
getting not in the church. There is a danger. When you are working the word of God, you can think that your heaven will be determined because of what you can perform. That day, then even God can say, check someone when he's in the word of God. The will of God is say what? I am dying on my will that I may do what is will.
Amen.
Are you understanding me?
Amen.
That is the number one
thing.
That means not my will, but his will. That means I receive him as a gift. I let him to control my life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That I may be submissive. Anytime you receive a gift, that means you submit. You let that gift to control. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why to receive Jesus is a gift.
It's
the number one requirement for you to get
power
and to move on. Are you understanding? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number two, the disciples are supposed to receive the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter
1
verse
8.
You shall receive power when the Holy Spirit will come upon you. What they are supposed to do when they receive that Holy Spirit is in the same way. It's like you say, I submit my will to the will of the Holy Spirit. I receive and I submit him to control my life. If you want to see power in yourself, submit to Jesus. Let Jesus control his will. God
needs
to control you, not the will of people, of denomination, of manipulation sometimes. I can tell you. Because there is no man can deliver
him.
There is no man can heal
him.
Are you understanding? All those ministries we can do, we do it by the grace of God, by what the Lord has done. We have to know how humble we can be.
If we
into our life. is very important. That means to receive the Holy Spirit is to submit. Many children of God, they don't receive
the Holy Spirit
because they don't believe in what the Lord says, and they
will
submit. It's not tomorrow, it can be now. I know when they go, they do that. Acts chapter 8. Let us go there quickly. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 8. Verse 14, the Bible says, now when the apostles who were at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had received the word of God, that means Samaria had received Jesus. That is salvation.
In
order to get power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When they heard that they received the word of God, they sent Peter and John to them, who when they had come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were just praying that those people they're supposed to submit in prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That we may receive the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Then they lay hands on them and they receive the Holy Spirit. Simple as good morning. Why are you trying to complicate
things?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We see the combination of the word of God. Because anyone who receives the word of God, the word of God will have authority over him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word of God will have authority over him. Because of that word of God,
they
will also receive the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 19. Let's go quickly. Verse 1 and verse 2. Because we still read the same book. The Bible says, and it happened when Apollos was at Corinth, that Paul, having passed through the upper region, came to Ephesus and found some disciples. He said to them, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believe? That means if you are a believer, there's nothing that can be
impossible.
Right there where you are, when you learn to submit, you can receive the Holy Spirit. Are you there? Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said to them, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believe? So they said to him, we have not so much as heard where there is the Holy Spirit. There is many people, they don't
know
where
there is the Holy Spirit.
You must know that you have to receive the Holy Spirit too. Hallelujah. I told you on the first Sunday, the difference between being baptized in the body and being baptized by Jesus with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't think because you have been saved, you receive the word of God, that means you receive the Holy Spirit. According to the word, you have to receive it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's the gift too, that means you have to submit to the offer of our God.
It's
for every believer. Hallelujah. And the Bible says in verse 3, and he said to them, into what then you were baptized? So they say into John Baptist.
John
Baptist was a baptism of repentance. It was in the
baptism.
Then Paul said, John indeed baptized with baptism of
repentance,
saying to people that they will believe in him, who will come after him. That is on Christ Jesus. Listen to the verse 5. When they heard this, it was when they received that word. When they heard that and they received it, the Bible says, they were baptized in the name of Jesus. That means they were baptized in the Holy Spirit. And Paul, spiritual authority lay hand on them, and they received the Holy Spirit upon them, and they started speaking new tongues. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Did you see how they received the word and how they received the Holy Spirit to activate the power that must become your desire? Hallelujah. That means we have to receive the word that was in the beginning to align to that wing, to submit ourselves. We have to receive the Holy Spirit. Because the Bible says, those that are sons, they are those by the Holy Spirit. Are you being led by your emotions, your feelings, your wrath of your hunger, your bitterness of your
heart?
From today, as I'm preaching to you, submit your will to the
Lord
of God. If you want to
grant
your future to be better, let me explain to you,
here
is a reality. Don't think it's a joke. When you are still alive here, it's the time to take it
seriously.
Because when Jesus was talking to the disciples in the book of Luke 16, he
made
mention about her. He was calling a place of darkness where there is no light. That means you can open your eyes wide. You cannot see someone. Those they can go to hell to see people,
but
except they can go by revelation. But the darkness is there. You cannot even recognize someone. The Bible calls it the place of two men. That being the place that can destroy you. The place of fire. And those they used to be there, they don't like a cup of water to be wet. They say, if you can just imagine someone, you are getting juice
and
but you still say you are suffering. For people, they cannot understand. Let me, there is a suffering. I warn you about it. Don't think because of many miles your life you can also suffer. Because there will be a time you cannot even get a cup of water. That means once you can get just one, but you will even never get
it.
It's how they suffer. Let me tell you, you know, even though they can get suicide, they think, oh, not kufa na ngai, let me just die to be well. Let me tell you, when you die in suicide, here you can get even water, but there you cannot even get a
clue.
It's better for you to
really say
that the Lord can help you
and
kill yourself. Because when you are going, you are going straight to hell. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even that day,
many
of you go to hell.
But to me,
Jesus will say, you say you are casting them
out.
You perform miracles. That's why Jesus said, rejoice because your name. Don't rejoice because the spirit is the sin
subjected.
Don't rejoice because the demon obey
you
and go. Rejoice because your name. Because your name. If I can ask you a question, is your name is
written
today? It's not because the demon that come me when they saw
you.
Make sure that you are
in the
Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That means we have to accept that gift. And to receive the gift. In other way, it means to
start
to that gift. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us close in Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians chapter 4 from verse 11. Hallelujah. The number 3 of what you must receive is the spiritual authority. And we will close from there. Because the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4 verse 11, himself gives some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers. Let me stop there. To be a pastor is not a gift.
Yes.
But a pastor is a gift.
Amen.
You cannot say, I have a gift to be a pastor. Follow them. He said to give some to be pastor. He did not give the gift of
pastor.
He gives some to be pastor. Because there are many people they think they can have the gift of the apostle.
No.
There is not a gift to be apostle.
An apostle
when it's in the will of God. Are you following me? That's why you will never be a pastor
or an apostle
if you are not healthy in the things of God. Are you understanding? It's not the title come first. It's the self-confess. That's why when you go in the book of Romans chapter 1, God said, I'm a
prophet
and apostle. Is the one who
wants.
Are you understanding? Because everything. If you want to see someone, how he can be great,
so
even in the church,
is
not that title. Because Jesus said, the one who wants to become great, let him become the last, let him become a servant of God. Even Jesus said, I did not come to be saved, I come to say that I may be who I am.
Timothy.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You want to go there, please.
2
Timothy chapter 2, verse 2.
The Bible
says, the things that you heard, teach it, submit it to the faithful, that they can be able to give it to others. What God is looking when we are preaching the word is your faithfulness. Is not your ability. Are you understanding me? We are not qualified for ministry because of our ability.
Let me tell you,
the path come.
Is
the water feed people?
Is
not the pipe. Is that your day? Oh, it's a mine.
Amen.
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 It's not the horse who feed or nourish people. It's the water. It's
a mine.
The horse, what he did, he said, I'm available. I will be faithful. That's my ecolica. Water will go to.
Oh, yes.
That's me. What will nourish people? Listen to me. It's not the pipe. It's not me. It's what I'm preaching. I'm just like a pipe. Where the water will go
to.
I'm not the one. That's why you have to believe to the water. There are even some pastors, you can see them well, including myself. Are you understanding
me?
But one day, why? Because what can really help you?
It's
not me as a man.
It's
my availability to let the ability of God
in
my ability that will heal you. It's not my ability that will deliver you. It's not my ability. For people able. God is looking for people that they are
faithful.
That you can be available. They can say, God, here I am. I'm faithful to come. I'm faithful to work, to do your work. When God is coming to you, it's not the people
of God
doing it. It's not by your mind. It's not by your power. It's by the Spirit of God. Kingdom, power, glory, belong to
me.
That means even at the end, you can say it's not to me. Because when sometimes you teach
me,
you can realize others, you can insult others, you can
insult others,
we are ministers by the grace of God, by God's ability. Let that ability come into your life. Let that ability come into your life. The Bible does not teach you that you cannot receive
a
spiritual man of God. No. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the spiritual authority. Many they believe in God. Many they can submit.
Jesus.
There are many in the church.
Today.
submit to the men of God. Many they forget that even God can be
God.
Can
walk
as his word
is
commanded to do. Listen. In Acts chapter 13, we are closing there.
Na Acts 13,
imagine how many closing now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In Acts 13.
Na Acts 13.
By the grace of God, maybe this can be the last close. Because there is many close. We did not close. When many things is coming. Acts 13.
Acts 13.
Let us go there, please.
Totally.
Now, in the church that was at Antioch, there were a certain prophets and teachers. Barnabas, Simeon, Manae, who has been brought up with Herod, the tetrarch and Saul, as the minister to the Lord, and fasted, the Holy Spirit said, now separate to me Barnabas and Saul
for the work
which I have called them. And having fasted and prayed and laid hands on them, they sent them away. When you follow this story, Paul was a member for 13 years in the church.
Amen.
Are you understanding me?
Amen.
Paul was a member. When the Holy Spirit said,
they're
supposed to lay hand on him. After many years, 13. He did not go because he decided that he has the ability. The Holy Spirit said, and as the Holy Spirit said,
I
am supposed to be laying on
him.
Let me tell you. You cannot say the Holy Spirit sends you if you go on your own. Because even Peter, they will go to Samaria. That means there is a level in our humanity. The Bible says God gives some apostles for the equipping of the saints. Are you there? For the building of the body of
Christ.
Let me tell you, if I'm a gift of this, I'm not super. Listen to me very well. I can be a gift for
you
to equip
you,
to train
you
for the work of the ministry. That I'm here to help any saint. The Bible says those saints, when they've been equipped, they will join each other. They will make grow the body of God. It's not the pastor who makes grow the church. It's not the pastor. A pastor equips the saints. When the saints they join, they will pray, they will do follow up, they will give, they will make for the change. Are you understanding? That means the saints that are more important than the church than the pastor. Why? You know you have a body. Right now. Your life. Just raise up your voice. Start to pray.